both left child 2, then the this child, right child, then we go back to the this root, and then actually the root of this, that is the root comes last, that is the post order, and eventually this is pre-order is connected with top-down parsing, and this is the bottom-up parsing. This is the way. There are other ways also, tree traversal, like you can traverse a tree by level wise, like you can traverse a tree like this way level wise, but that is no role in our parsing. So this is the famous another way, another traversal way. I can do it pre-order from that way, right child first, but that is not also the convention. Always the left child first, pre-order. So here also in post order we go for the left tree, so it is goes to our LR1 parsing, bottom up parsing, or equivalently you can say with the LR1, it is left to right, but right hand rule match first, and it is LL1, left to right, and left hand rule first, that is LL1. So this is the today's topic, pre-order and post-order. Pre-order is connected with top-down parsing, and post-order is bottom-up parsing. This is very important diagram. I always mention this is, we are all programming languages context-free, and theoretical limit is O(n) cube. N is the number of terminal symbols. Number of terminal symbols are huge. See, in any programming languages, that all syntaxes, all identifiers, even a 100 line programs, it may be 1000 or 10th, minimum 1000 or 2000. So n cube is a huge number, so we cannot permit O(n) cube. We should be limited, our programming languages parsing should be O(n), for we have to make it linear. That is the, and that is also unambiguous grammar and deterministic context free grammar. All are the context free. There is a subset of deterministic context free grammar, deterministic context free language. That language should have a grammar which is unambiguous, and that also have the restriction. We have to make it, the parsing should be O(n). So that's it. Here it is the view of the compiler stages. Lexical analyzer we have already covered in our classes. The lexical analyzer, the you all symbol table filling it up. Then the syntax analyzer. Here there are two approach. One is top down parsing, that is pre-order, that is you visit the root first, and another is a bottom up parsing, that is post order, tree traversal, and then the semantic analyzer we'll consider later. Same thing, the symbol table, this is the most crucial point. It is made, it is generally maintained in a hash table. Parsing, I have told O(n) cube is not acceptable, too slow. So two linear type LL, but LL parser, that is left to right, leftmost, and another thing we have learned today, that is a pre-order tree traversal, and it is LR parser, left to right, rightmost, and that is a post-order tree traversal. And we will find that LR parser is more general, it can accommodate more general languages. Yes, this thing I want to clear, this is the parsing tree, it should be like it basically what you want to mean this one, but in compiler instead of parse tree they try to make it a abstract syntax tree. There is subtle difference here, the operands are here and his operation is here. So this is the difference between the parse tree and abstract syntax tree. Both are equivalent, so and 1:1 compatible. So compiler the parse tree and abstract syntax tree are more or less same, but abstract syntax tree here is the result, and these are the operand arguments, say it plus sign, minus sign. This is compiler uses abstract syntax tree, so same as the parse tree, and that should be unique after bottom up parsing or top down parsing. Here it is a parsing top down. Top down, another is backtracking, whether it can fire a rule, then it is fine, no it is not acceptable, it backtrack and fire another rule. So this is okay for limited number of terminals, maybe 20, 30, backtracking is okay, but thousands of terminals, the backtracking is not possible. It takes huge time complexity. It will definitely not linear. It will take space. It can go in groups. So the grammar has to be modified, so that there should not be backtracking. We will prefer the predictive parser. Predictive parser, there should be no backtracking allowed, and it is only possible if the grammar follows certain rule, like all the production rules. The first element, by checking the first element, we can predict which rule to fire. So it is good for it is mandatory for LL1 grammar. LL1 means I can look at only one terminal, so that if seeing the one terminal, I can fire the rule. There should be no backtracking, but the grammar rule has to be tweaked or has to be modified for predictive parsers. Here we are showing an example of backtracking. See here, we have the say input string is BCD. How to get BCD? This is our rules. And say first I try to this one BAB backtrack, BAB backtrack. So because our this thing is BCD, so go for this BA. So go for BA, and then you say here first go for BCD, the BB matches, but BAB BCD not match, so dead end. Then go for S is equal to BCD. Then you go for this match, like this match, then it is success. So it will always a dead end backtrack here, one dead end backtrack here, so then finally it matches. So this is a backtracking mode in the top down parsing. I am getting from the root, always starts from the root and try to matches at the BCD. So backtracking takes cannot be linear. It space complexity higher, and definitely time complexity higher. So we will not consider backtracking for programming languages. Here is a top down parser. What the does it? They first visit the root and then go to the left child, then again further to left child, is a depth first. This first, and also root is the first, so pre-order. Depth first, pre-order. This one is matches the terminal. So it, if the matches, then it try to matches T2. This is the basic thing. If it find it here, fine, that will match. Then it again backtracks. So this is the top-down parsing. So it is a in or it is first in root pre-order and pre-order, and also it checks the depth first and matches the rule. Bottom-up parser is reverse. It tries to matches the rule from the right-hand side. The rules can form it up. That is a bottom-up parser. Principal bottom-up parsing consider the nodes in syntax in post-order, unlike pre-order here in top. And top of the subtree is constructed after all these lower nodes have been constructed. When a bottom-up parser constructs a node, all its children have already been constructed, are present and known. The level of the node itself is also known. The parser creates a node, labels it, and connects it to it. Bottom-up parsing it goes from the right-hand side, so that it makes to the root. This is an example, another top-down parsing. So these are the context-free grammar, and this is the string. The first, we have to start from S to AB. Then A has two rules, either this or this. So it takes the rule AA. It can go epsilon also, but then there will be no other further A. So one look ahead can be always done. So it fires AA, then another AA, another AA, then put epsilon. This is a top-down way of this grammar. These are the grammar. And this is the same thing in the bottom-up. But the bottom-up trick is, I am trying to match it from this way. The rules are same. I have to put first a epsilon, insert epsilon, and then I have to fire this root. I put the epsilon here, then I put this root. First this root, then this root, then this root, then I finally reaches. So tricky is that you have to intelligently put a epsilon here to fire this root. Comparison, this is the top down parsing and this is the bottom up parsing. The bottom up parsing, the trick is you have to place this epsilon. Yes, these are the again and again will come to true. This is the top down parsing with full backtracking, that is should be avoidable. This cannot be ON linear, and this is with backtracking. One is recursive descent and is non-recursive descent. Non-recursive descent is the is our target LL1. The backtracking, one solution is the implement backtracking that I have already mentioned, that is backtracking is not allowed. Backtracking takes time, not away. For non-recursive descent, we have to, that is the LL1 grammar, that is the linear, definitely guaranteed linear, but the rules has to be modified. What are the rules? That the first, what is the one particular thing is first and follow. First function, if we do it for all terminal, first function for terminal is always a terminal. First function should a string, should be first function of its first available variable, or non-terminal or terminal. First function of a terminal is a terminal. First function of a variable, if the variable goes to epsilon, then it will be the first function will call or come will include the follow function of that variable. Follow function I'll come later. The first function means if we allow first function, if you apply on a variable or any string, what is the first terminal it will bring? So the so every rule on the right hand side, if we make a first, if they give the terminal which are different, then LL1 is possible. That is a necessary condition, not sufficient condition. So one thing is we have to put first function of all the production rules on the of all the variables on the left hand side and all the right hand side. We'll see the first function should not have any common terminal. So if a common terminal is there, then which rule to fire, that would be difficult. And then you have to go backtracking mode. Backtracking is not allowed because backtracking is time consuming, not ON. So if we tweak the modify the rules so that the first function first of all the on the right hand side of all the rules are disjoint, so no terminal is common, then it is necessary condition for LL1 grammar. There are other conditions also. This is computing first and follow. I have told two functions we have to compute for the context switch grammar. One is first, another is follow. This is how to create a first function. Say if a rule is like this, say if a rule is like it is the x1 dot x2 like this, compute the first and follow. So if u1 go to this, so if x1 is a terminal, then x add x1 and first two and it's finished. So your rule is u is going to this, so x1 is a terminal, then if all this first of one is first of u is definitely that terminal. If x1 goes to epsilon, then it will be the first of x2. This is okay. So we'll make it clear in our next classes. First and follow, it'll go into the details. Thank you very much.